Since 1976, Basco Paints has been manufacturing paint and now has also taken up the role of providing products which are health conscious. Joining me in the studio is Basco Paints Managing Director, Mr. Kamlesh Shah, to talk further. Welcome.
Thank you, Malika.
All right, now let's get right into the conversation by, you know, touching first on Basco Paints and the range of products you manufacture in the country.
Well, there's a wide range of products we do. The premium qualities, the trade qualities, and the economies range. As per the Kenya Bureau of Standards, those are the three categories. But those are quite broad. We've got all kinds of textured effects. We've got all kinds of technological affiliations.
Yes.
With international players. And yeah, it's a well-established company. It's 42 years old, and yeah, it's thriving.
Okay. Now, of course, when we talk about manufacturing paints, you've also now recently talked about the fact that, you know, we need to be more health conscious and environmentally conscious as well when it comes to producing these products. So I believe that it's fueled quite a few different products that you've brought into the market.
So what happened is we realized as early as in 2003 that something, for instance, like lead, in lead dryers was a poisoning element, and we actually substituted lead dryers with other dryers in paint compositions. And then in 2011, we moved on forward and we did the low VOC or the low volatile organic compounds, what we call the eco-friendly paints. And we do believe that there's a lot of harmful substance in the VOC-based standard formulations.
Okay.
Normal paints carry a lot of these volatile organic compounds that tend to harm children as well as grown-ups because you tend to breathe that in your day-to-day lives while the paint is still wet, it has not dried, and the solvent that carries the volatile organic compounds tends to evaporate, obviously, in order to dry the film. And as the film of the paint cures, there are dust particles that also come into play. And these create harmful effects, anything ranging from mild headaches to respiratory problems, to in extreme cases and extreme exposures, to things like asthma. The eco-friendly paints tend to help us not to have all of those, because the normal paints also have one very serious effect, Malika, that people are not realizing so often.
Yes.
And that is the formation of smog. Smog is something that contributes to global warming.
True.
And smog is something that's produced when these volatile organic compounds react with other emission substances from industrial plants, from motor vehicles, from all the other toxic substances that
Yes.
affect the environment. And that smog, again, obviously affects the ozone layer that we are so susceptible and do not want to lose away.
So contributes to global warming as well when it comes
to
the effects of such products. And so, you know, when you mention these lower volatile organic compounds, can you break that down for us? Because, of course, unlike chemists, we wouldn't understand what these are.
Well, basically, we have moved from a lot of inorganic to organic substances and primarily to substances that do not have emissions beyond, say, 30 parts per milliliter or 30 parts per million in any paint composition. And those are European standards, those are paint research association standards. And we were the first ones in this country to have low VOC as well as lead-free Duracoat decorative range of paints. And we do feel that this is a value addition substance.
Okay.
There is no cost implication to it as far as the consumer is concerned, although it costs us more, but that's something that we do believe will give us returns in the future as more and more Kenyans we have seen do become more aware of all kinds of global knowledge.
Okay.
In terms of harmful substances and so on.
All right, now when you talk about lead prevention, you recently had a partnership, I believe, to promote this agenda as well.
Yes. So there was a whole week of lead poisoning prevention week.
Mm-hmm.
That was spearheaded by the University of Nairobi and the United Nations Environment program, and we were the main sponsors of this. We have actually been sponsoring this endeavor by Dr. Farida Vere, who is a senior lecturer at the University of Nairobi in the chemistry department.
Okay.
And we have been there with her for the last 4 to 5 years
mm-hmm.
in all kinds of sponsorships. The whole idea is to highlight the harmful effects of lead in the paint. People do not want to sort of move away from conventional paints and say cheap is actually not cheap, and expensive in the long term is actually a much better value-added proposition.
Okay.
So we have had situations where lead has been known worldwide to form anything between respiratory problems, children having mental disorders, or you know, slower development of the brain and so on, to extreme cases, as we all know, of lead poisoning and carcinogenous elements in a few individuals worldwide.
Okay.
And the one thing that the country can do, the government can do, is actually ban any kind of lead-based pigments importation or lead-based dryers importation, whereby you have, you may not be able to completely minimize this, but you want to create an even playing field everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
So there are about 65 to 70 paint companies, and there are only 4 or 5 top tier companies that are actually complying with this kind of regulation voluntarily, since it has not been, you know, enforced by the authorities.
Okay.
However, it is high time that this is done,
mm-hmm.
and to create an even playing field, the masses who are actually suffering with the buying of the mainly the economy range, as I mentioned, as per Kenya Bureau of Standards, there are 3 standards of paint: the premium, the trade, and the economy. Now, the economy is the cheapest paint in terms of value for money, and it is also used by masses. 70% of the population would actually be using the economy-based paint.
So this is the paint that then does not have that regulation when it comes
yes.
to these harmful components.
Correct.
Okay.
And we would very much like that if there is an even playing field, then the technology is present for all the paint companies
mm-hmm.
to be able to produce lead-free paints, to be able to produce eco-friendly paints,
okay.
and be able to support the economy and the country and the common consumer at large.
Okay, so you've touched on quite a few different things, but you know, I want to broaden the conversation. You've talked about imports, we've talked about harmful components in products, manufacturing these products, and when it comes to manufacturing, and as we know, it's the part of the Big Four agenda of President Kenyatta's. You know, it's a big pillar, and the government does hope that it will contribute 15% of the GDP by 2020. But how conducive is the current environment in the country right now to facilitate big-scale manufacturing? As of course, you have been around over 40 years now, and Basco has been manufacturing these paints right here. How have you seen these challenges evolve?
What has happened over time is that we have had to improvise, meander ourselves as manufacturers, and I think I speak for the industry at large, in order to somehow, you know, get to the end results that we have actually experienced. What has happened is that there are, it's like, I think, typical of most developing countries, Malika. It's something like you take 2 steps forward and you take 1 step back. And then again, you try to take 2 steps forward, and just when you think everything is going well, then suddenly some things, you know, go awry.
Yes.
For instance, the SGR railway, it was a very, very, and it still is a very, very promising element
mm-hmm.
to be able to give us efficiency. However, what has happened, obviously, is that there are delays at the Kenya port in loading up the containers, in the clearing of those containers inland, and all that has created a bottleneck for us. The tariff rates in electricity also had shot up a lot. Fortunately, recently the president said the small and medium enterprises should be given a reprieve on this.
Yes.
You have seen the kerosene. Kerosene goes into manufacturing of paints.
Mm-hmm.
And in a bid for the prevention of adulteration of the fuels for motor vehicles, the government decided that we've got to put on an extra price for kerosene. However, majority of the people, in the country actually use that for lighting purposes.
True.
And the other part is that we as paint manufacturers, a good substance of our solvents are actually kerosene.
So did that hit you very hardly when it came to your cost?
It did, it did. For instance, most of the premium quality paint companies have had to do a price revision upwards in the last month and a half. Mm. And ultimately, that will result in the shorter term, prices going up. In the middle and long term, depleted demand. Mm. Because if you cannot afford, what do you do?
It's not sustainable.
It's not sustainable. So if you would think ideally I should paint every 2 years, you may take it to two and a half, and so on.
So the Finance Act 2018 and the implications it had are wide varying then, especially with manufacturing.
Yes, absolutely. And then obviously the other effect, the general effect of the petrol, the increase in the
8%
VAT. The 8% VAT. Mm. Now that has also created an inflation for the general community, not just manufacturers. So fortunately, when we look at it and from a macro level, mm-hmm. Kenya is the third best destination for investors to come in Africa. And this was as per the recent results that came out of a report. And what we do feel is that perhaps, as I mentioned earlier, two steps forward and one step back is what we carry on doing. We would obviously hope that we are able to move forward, more rapidly and be more and more conducive to meet that particular
True.
Instance of that pillar
Yes.
of manufacturing.
Okay, and as we continue that, let's even go a bit further, because as we speak, the China International Import Expo is happening in Shanghai. Some economists have actually been advising that the platform should be used to discuss policies that can be created to enable manufacturing to happen in the country. So we don't have that vicious cycle where we're providing the raw materials, that's what we're exporting, but then they're produced, they're manufactured, they're finished, a finished product is sold to us at a much greater price, and we provided that raw material at a much cheaper price. So, the markup, of course, there hits us hard. But what is your take on this trend, on how we've seen China moving into the country, especially when it comes to competition for manufacturers within the country?
Well, on the one side, Malika, obviously competition is healthy. But having said that, it has to be a fair competition. It has to be something where you got to take into consideration it's like who is more handicapped and who is less handicapped to do the gambit. Unfortunately, what has happened is that China worldwide, as we have seen, and is no longer a secret in that, is lending a lot of money to the developing world, mm-hmm. but at huge collateral costs, at huge security costs. And some countries have unfortunately seen losing their port, losing their copper mines, losing some industry of theirs, a critical element of that country or that economy.
True.
And this has been what you might call not the blessing that we were hoping it was. There was a time when we used to criticize the Western world and say, look, these guys have got lots of strings attached in lending to us. Mm-hmm. Now this seems, this used to be looking like a great boon, but there are downsides to this as well. That is not to say that we should not make use of that facility, but we must, have our leaders and leaders of the African countries at large to be able to analyze and properly bifurcate and dissect and see the downside of things, that should things go really wrong, what is at stake?
Okay.
So, when they say you hope for the best, but you prepare for the worst, mm-hmm. are you really prepared for the worst? It's a very, very critical concept that needs and demands a lot of thought, a lot of conscientious thinking, because leaders will come and go. The people are the ones who are going to inherit either the legacies or the curses of bad decisions.
Thank you so much. On that very poetic note, Mr. Kamlesh, I really appreciate you taking time to come and talk to us on Business Today.
Thank you so much, and I would just like to take this opportunity to wish all of our Hindu viewers, we are right now on the eve of Diwali. I just want, on behalf of happy Diwali, a very, very prosperous, joyful, and successful, and fruitful new year coming day after tomorrow.
Fantastic.
Thank you so much
for
this opportunity.
All right. Thank you. Now, let's move on from that interesting conversation. Flip the script on the much talked about launch of Kenya Airways nonstop flights to the U.S. and